Sheikh Saleh Al-Talib, who was the previous imam at the Masjid of Mecca, was arrested and sentenced to 10 years. What did he say that caused him to be arrested? Here is a clip of the sermon.
احذروا الحفلات الغنائية الكوميدية والسينمائية وإن زعموا أنها ترفيهية فما هي إلا مشاريع تغريبية بخطوات مدروسة تدريجية وضوابط تغريبية لا ضوابط شرعية ألبسوها أثوابا جذابة ومغرية وغلفوها بمعاني التغيير والتجديد للأفضل ترفيه ليس لهم عندهم بدائل غير المجون والغناء والرقص والاختلاط ما هو إلا عار وخزي ونذير شؤم على البلاد حينما يقدم الشواذ كقدوة للشباب أيها المترفون المترفهون إنكم تنفقون أموال الناس على برامجكم التافهة بغير حق ولا فائدة تنفقونها ثم تكون عليكم حسرة ثم تغلبون نعم ستغلبون في معركة القيم والأخلاق سيغلبكم المجتمع الذي لا يزال ثابتا على دينه مهما تعثر أوضعه لن يقبل المجتمع أن يكون الترفيه مستوردا لأقذر ما في الثقافة الغربية لإفساده وتمييع عقيدته وقيمه وأخلاقه ستغلب برامجكم حلقات تحفيظ القرآن الكريم التي تحاربونها ستغلبكم مآذننا السامقة التي تدوي الله أكبر الله أكبر كل يوم وليلة خمس مرات فتلامس أسماعنا.
He has a right to enjoin the good and forbid the evil, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clearly told us. And this is very important because Allah says in the Quran to Bani Israel, He told them not to fish in the Sabbath. Group of them, when they started still fishing in the Sabbath, not listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's orders, there was three categories the scholars say. The first one was those who saw them doing that and they didn't say anything about it. The other one was the ones who saw it and spoke out against it. And there was the other one which basically they promoted. Oh, they just said, look, no problem, you're gonna do whatever you like. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the ones that fished at the Sabbath. But the scholars say the ones who were watching and not doing nothing about it were also destroyed. Why? Because they were the silent devil. It is very, very crucial for us as believers to enjoin good and forbid evil. Because if you don't, you see society perpetually going down the route of haram because nobody is coming and saying stop. It's sickening. It's disgraceful. And it shows where the kingdom of Saudi Arabia is going. Senses the sheikh just by saying ittaqillah, fear Allah, free mixing, concerts and all this kind of stuff. And telling them, reminding them of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he gets 10 years in prison. I'm not saying every single person in Saudi Arabia believes this. Some are silent, some are quiet. I'm not asking anybody to come and rebel. But the least we can do is enjoin the good and forbid evil with our circles. Ibn Taymiyyah, he was imprisoned. And he said, what can you do to me when my Jannah is in my heart? You can lock him up because he has that connection with his Lord. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy on him and that he gets closer to his Lord in the serving of this 10 years unjustly. He didn't ask for rebellion. All he did was enjoin the good and forbid the evil. And we should all do that. It's a sad reality that we live in and shows us the signs of the day of judgment that is coming closer.